повернусь.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I'm really so happy and so proud to be invited by such a small team whom really I'm very proud of the infrastructure here. I was lucky to know Dr. Shammari and the whole hospital professional team when I worked 14 years in the hospital here. And really I can say that there is what's called post-Kenny Faisal sickness syndrome, because really this place applies everybody. If you walk in this place, you will feel that you can never perform practice anywhere. You will always suffer that you want to be optimized everywhere you are going. This is, I cannot say because just say, no, this is true facts. With all the respect, it's not a matter of infrastructure materials. It's not a matter of resources. For example, I can say, for example, National Guard, we have military, we have big private like that. Resources are there. But King Faisal, since Allah irhamu King Faisal, it really gives a very, very unique touch here. You feel that there is a special atmosphere. The will the people, the will the colleagues, the will the, it's really distinguished. So this is to start with. I have to, in short, I have to resign to go back to my country to get my degree from my university, and then came back for Qasim to open a real transplant project. During my stay, and proud to Shammari, I noticed him that how he started to build the vascular intervention units. And since that time, I realized that vascular intervention is a real backbone for any hospital, I can say it. When I went to Qasim, I realized this. I was faced that I am working in a region, not a hospital. 16 hospitals are drained to pink fat, 16 hospitals by name. I worked for 6 years, imagine. 16 hospitals, all of them they have dialysis units, all of them receive trauma, including also adding to it its King Fahd hospital. Not only that, in few meters you have Prince Sultan Cardiac Center, which is really very smart center and they're producing a lot of cases. They are doing, for example, 10 cases cast lab per day. And they remind me in King Faisal that you never sleep unless they finish work, because you can anticipate at any time brain complication. We have been invited and involved in the recent TAVI program, which is transfemoral aortic valve replacement, that it means that, for example, you might have iatrogenic injury at any time to a major vessel. But luckily, they have experience, and for example, they used a covered stent in 3 cases, and they saved a lot of laboratories. We have done with Dr. Shammari since 2000, the first 3 cases of endovascular aortic stenting here in King Faisal. And when we went there, we found what is the solution. I don't have an entry suite, and excuse me that it is unfortunate to say that I have to be truth. We don't have vascular lab, number one. We don't have interventional units. We don't have entry suites. This is just true. All what we are depending on a proper CT, which gives you the final decision. Doppler-wise, we don't have specific vascular Doppler. So we receive a lot of confusion in the reports, because the radiologist today is working in mammogram, tomorrow he's in CT, after he's in whatever, MRI, like that. So this is I'm speaking in a language of quality. This is the standard language, which is what? SWOT. Let us say SWOT. What is SWOT? SWOT means strengths. Strengths that we could have dealt with all this. The fear from gynae, for example, major injuries after cesarean section, a lot of trauma we are facing, vascular access. We have also an oncology, Prince Bandar Oncology Center. And this is for the first time since 6 years when we joined there, we started to back up their access for oncology. So they started their own chemotherapy. Here we know that at least in any oncology patient nowadays, at least he needs 4 types of clusters. For example, if you have an acute leukemia, you have to precondition the bone marrow first by high flow cluster to remove the antibodies. And then, for example, when you do transplant, you have to give an intermittent chemo by either decline or WM or TBM and Hickman cluster. If you go home, you can give intermittent chemo on a long term like a port. So to have this challenge, establishing all different types of vascular access for oncology is another thing. We face a lot of complications from cardiac cath. For example, our colleague kindly talked about closure devices nowadays. Closure devices, it's used in a very high flow in our center, because it's all complications. Even I was about to ask about what is the rule in case we have cases of pathological device, patient good colitis, and some of them even good ischemia. And this is another channel. So my message is that I don't like to be boring, but I'm telling through the lecture what's that. Qasim is missed in the map of Saudi Arabia. This is my feeling. Qasim needs a lot of investment, medical investment. The people need support by anyway. 16 hospitals lacking rail. God, and with God's help, alhamdulillah, without the backup of the intervention, hospital intervention units, we could have been frozen and we could have been in a mess. At least nowadays, our list, there is hardly you find like us in our OR list. Because most of the 90% of the cases now are going into the intervention hospitals. So our vascular team, smart vascular team in King Faisal, we know the capacity that they have a chronic problem. 6 beds, you have to cover the whole kingdom by in 6 beds, or even 4 beds. So it means that he should never be stuck, honestly. Practically, we should not expect from our colleague in vascular King Faisal to be stuck in a bypass or a diabetic foot which can delay his admission plan like that. We know how precious bed in King Faisal. So based on this fact, we built a great relationship with our vascular department here, potential unit, and we are proud, and they are the reason for success, honestly. Nowadays, we are trying to build, we succeeded to do more than 25 cases of aortic aneurysm stenting in Breda. Nobody, of course, can imagine how it comes to Breda without an angio suite, and we are doing an endovascular. Because we come to the second point of SWOT analysis. S means strengths. We talk about strengths. What about O? O is opportunities. We got the opportunity to use the cath lab of Prince of Pancasic Center to do aortic aneurysm stenting, both thoracic and the abdominal. And I think through hearing Dr. Zamer and Dr. Omran, really, they are giving a great support. And once we call them that we have this case so and so, they immediately, the only response is that, okay, send the image, let us process on the graft, we are coming. So I can say it frankly, that we appreciate, and this is another success which I cannot deny it. And in Qasim, we say, these are the team from Riyadh. We never say our names before, because we don't like to steal the success from the others. Everybody should think as well. So we talk about the opportunities that we use. What about SWAT, SCW? OT, W is weakness. Our weakness is, as I mentioned, that we didn't have an angio. There is a promise that there will be an ON unit which will be established in coming September. This is what we are. But again, I talked to my radiologist that please don't expect that when you establish an angio suite, don't expect that we will refer to you a case for diagnostic angio. Because nowadays there is no what's called SIND for angio for diagnosis. CT high resolution now becomes the answer most 99% of the questions. So it means that we should be ready with the interventional backup to have this suite to work with. What about the threats? Threats, which is a T. So SWOT, the T is the threats. What is the threats? People are increasing in number, diabetics are increasing in number, and there may be a question mark about the highest incident in the kingdom, again in the Qasim. Somebody will try to relate it to gates or habits, traditions, I'm not sure, but it is rough to estimate that Qasim is there. As I mentioned, Qasim is not on the map. I dreamed to put it on the map by doing, for example, an international meeting, which can invite the whole world, invite 16 dialysis unit with all the staff, and I give the idea, Dr. Shemari was, Dr. Samir were willing to support and start to work on this one. And inshallah, Dr. Omran, I'm sure he will share me in the same principles. And Dr. Feder, that to start with, let us focus on the problem. Let us, all the world knows what is Qasim. Let us, American Airlines land in Qasim Airport. This is my concept. So,
not United. Yeah? Not United.
It's the only direct flight to Morocco from Saudi Arabia.
Sorry?
It's the only direct flight to Morocco from Saudi Arabia.
Excellent. And so, my I don't like to have my discussion to be boring for you at the end of the day, but to summarize it, let us say that we have a problem, major problem. There is a threat that the people are increasing. My point is that King Faisal is doing its best. And Mr. Rais, I know him since more than 17 years now. And when I came to King Faisal, I was wondering, what does it mean outreach? And when I went to Qasim, I realized that outreach means that King Faisal is satisfied by reaching to the highest caliber of patient service. They are satisfied. Next step is to go and do transfer their experience, transfer their help to other like them. My point is that, is any hope or any sort of idea that to do satellite centers in the big regions, for example, Qasim is one, I can say one third of the middle of the Kerala, any chance to make, to build a unit, not a competitive unit, it will be a daughter for a mother, big mother, supervised and done running by the same team. Because what I'm afraid about my colleagues, they mentioned the waiting list, it is a threat. Because I know the capacity, whatever the manpower fee, whatever the time, you are killed, I know. You are kindly, you are calling sometimes at 5 o'clock or 6 p.m. And, oh my God, these people are hurt. They have how much radiation they are exposed since the morning like that. So what I mean is that, my suggestion is that one day we have to expand and do our satellite service. This is what I'm saying. Second point about scientifically, why we should stress about now the diabetic food program. What has changed? Diabetic people are since more than 100 centuries. Why are we focusing now on diabetic food? Because now there is big revolution in the management. Before, I used to work in a diabetic unit. We used to do above knee amputation for one big two ganglion. Simple. Because the answer, if you go for bilirubin, you cannot predict. You might revise it. And the phobia of the surgeon to revise an amputee, we all feel it. To say to the family that let us go again above. So everybody was shot him from above to be sure that he will not come back. This is nowadays, which we are using the term is now, instead of limb salvage, we are talking about food salvage. And by food salvage, we are coming back to the new terminology, to the old terminology. This France amputation, how many times we have heard it for the last years? Schuppart, we never heard about it. Tooth amputation. I can congratulate you, but I don't have statistics. But since the last visit, we started to feel how far important that every center should do his own statistics. So that you can, when you are faced with the higher authority, is it so big like that? Oh, we have these numbers, we have this together. So I promise you that from my center, we'll start on working and building an infrastructure of database. You can use it because I'm sure that you will soon face major problems in running the program. So number one, so the revolution came that the advances in intervention, nowadays the people are doing microangioplasty. Before, as a surgeon, we used to find that Noran off, desert food, amputation. The only thing, let us try antiprostaglandin and give him a chance. But nowadays we have what's called the microangioplasty to angio. We have some intimate angioplasty to revascularize a dead or almost a desert foot. Again, what is the next advances? Wound management. Dr. Amran, he talked about 100 material dressing. Very excited. Because the last recommendation from the American Wound College of Wounds, they said that please treat the diabetic ulcer like a friend. Say to him, how are you today? Are you dry? I should moist you by some aqua gel. Are you wet? I should take oxidate by some scent. Are you infected? I will put some silver. Are you smelly? I will put some carbon. Like that. So dealing with the diabetic wound is a dynamic process. That's why the latest recommendation, Dr. Shamarian, he was by me at this point, when the Italian team came, they recommended that there is nothing called diabetic center will close on Wednesday afternoon and then come back on Sunday morning. These 3 days, we are the one who face this problem. Diabetic food considered like a camel, which you cannot predict where he's going. He can escape at any time. The last time patient seen Wednesday in the morning, fine. Thursday in the night, gas forming organism. You have these scenarios going on. You have a patient. So it means the last recommendation is to make available surgeon available 24 hours per day and 7 days per week. There's nothing called, once you have got the responsibility to lead a diabetic center, you should run the service the whole week. So I don't like to have more time, but in conclusion, the advances in wound care, the advances in microangiography, the advances in understanding the mechanics, foot mechanics, this is a big topic we all know about the orthotics. The orthotic department is built on more understanding of foot form. Before we used the Charcot equal what? Equal amputation. Nowadays we have a smart orthotic surgeon who's interested in sharp joint surgery. He used to chop the joint, he need to put a graft and make an arthrodesis to change the weight bearing like that. We used to have, for example, the term ulcer heal, no heal. It means that if you have a calcaneal ulcer, forget about healing. Change the concept. We are doing a microvascular, we are doing a partial calcaneectomy. You can remove up to 60% of the calcaneus, but preserve the foot. What has it changed? The people has studied that when you do balloon amputation and they give the best prosthesis, they found that by follow-up, the patient, they are getting depression, they are not using practically the prosthesis, and they die within the five years of starting prosthesis. Touching the ground is nothing like touching the ground. So you have to fight even to preserve calcaneus to touch the ground. Lastly, I remember I say that we all, as a human, when we reach, inshallah, by the age of 70, by 75, 80, your dream in life is to go dependent to the bathroom without support. So imagine, believe me, I hear it from the patients that God gave me the support just to be able to go to depend on myself with healing my breath. This is my last, and I'd like to thank you very much. And I'm really proud of being here with all the smart stuff.
Yes, I have a comment about, the seam is neglected. The seam is neglected, I don't know what about the others. They are taking most of the budget. Maybe something wrong with the management. Yeah,